afternoon. My name is Ricardo Lucas, and welcome to Contractors Corner, a conversation about development and economic growth in the Kansas City community. My guest this afternoon is none other than Mr. Forrest Tyson Jr., co-owner of the Tycon Construction Company at 4435 Prospect. Welcome, Mr. Tyson.
Appreciate it, bro.
All right. I don't know how many times this man had to tell me about his name. It's not Tyson, it's Tycon for the construction company.
Right.
How long you guys been up there?
Oh, Tycon, we're 12, 13 years strong now.
Yes, sir. I know it's a family business, and I know the family takes pride in the business. Every time I go through the doors there, I see family working, I see people in the community working. Tell me what it was like for you to come up in a construction company with your family.
I'm second generation, and I know people have heard of that saying, you're born with a silver spoon in your mouth. Well, I was born with a silver shovel.
Yes, sir.
I didn't have a choice.
Yes, sir.
I knew I was going to be doing this. And, you know, my dad is the youngest of eight brothers, 13 kids total. And all the brothers except for one who had the good sense to be an electrician became a master electrician.
Yes, sir.
But we've always been in construction. And like I said, I'm second generation, and I've just been blessed, man. I've been blessed to never had to look for a job. Mm-hmm. I never had to fill out an application because my dad and my uncles provided a way for me, which is how it should be. So, you know, I count my blessings every day.
Appreciate it. You made a good point about starting a family-owned business. I think Gates is probably the oldest family-owned business. Gates and Sons Barbecue is probably the oldest family-owned business here in Kansas City. But I believe you're one of the largest construction companies here in the Kansas City area. You hire a lot of African-Americans in our community. How do you feel like the contracting industry treats you when you go through the door looking for work? Because I know when you get a contract, I can see that contract playing out in the streets in our community. So how do they treat you when you go through the door?
You know, that's one of those things that I've never been able to put my finger on because this is a competitive bid process kind of thing.
Right.
The struggle for us that has over the years has been that half of the time we've been subcontractors. Mm-hmm. We weren't in the prime contractor arena. But it's a good feeling to be in that arena because you're at the table with the guys that have, you know, or the GC on the project, you know. So you're not giving away a lot of your profit to the GC. You're holding some of that money back into your own company to build your own company. So it's a different arena, and it's a great feeling to be at the table versus, you know, outside hoping somebody give you some work.
Now, these big projects that come through town, Sprint, the 8 cent sales tax, the GO bond, got KCI coming, Cerner. How do they treat small contractors like yourself?
Again, that's the arena. And my dad, the experience that I've been given has prepared us for things just like that. We actually got one of the first packages of the GO bond that came out. Still waiting on contracts, but we were low, and it was $1.3 million. That's a lot of sidewalk. It's going to put a few guys to work. And it doesn't take us long to go through $1.5 million of work either. So we constantly look for one. We're looking for the next package, and we'll be a bidder on that.
The lack of skilled trade workers. And the emphasis had been on bachelor's degrees for the last 20 years, and that the skilled workers are not there. How do you fill that void for you, for your company?
Previously, it's been through genes. It's been family. It's not like it was when I was growing up. You know, my dad could take me to a construction site at 10, 11, 12 years old. You know, I'm proud to say that at, you know, 13, 14 years old, I was making $7.50 an hour. That's minimum wage now. That's 30 years ago. Right. You know, but I was able to go to a construction site. Well, you can't do that anymore.
Right.
In our industry, in our specialty, you have to know what you're doing. You know, I can't afford to train a guy, you know, for prevailing wage.
Right.
You have to know what you're doing. That training component has always been a homegrown kind of component.
Given the fact that workforce is built on the way it is, do you feel like the union is shrinking our workforce? You feel like the union is taking our work, eroding our work product and our workforce for their benefit, but it's not really benefiting us if we have all of our skilled workers are going to union jobs and we can't get the union jobs?
Well, being a student of the union, I'm not fond of the union as far as we're concerned,
yeah,
because we're the last hired, first fired. I mean, and it's one of those things where the benefits of the union do not, from my, you know, viewpoint, benefit us. I can't say that. I say that from personal experience. And when you say trades and things like that, I have a problem with the union mentality. My dad didn't teach me to be a laborer. He didn't teach me to be a finisher. He didn't teach me to be a truck driver. He didn't teach me to be a form setter. He didn't teach me to be an accountant. He didn't teach me to be an operator. He taught me to be all of those things. So, and the premise behind that was that you're never without work. That's the mentality. That's how I was raised, and that's the industry. That's how my dad introduced me to the industry. Know all the trades.
You know, I know I've had the opportunity to.
And the unions don't allow you to do that. If you're a laborer, that's all you're gonna do is
right.
Labor. If yes, you're sir. A cement mason, that's all you're gonna do is finish concrete. Yes. If you're an operator, you better not touch a finishing tool.
Yes.
You know, that's the mentality, and that's not how we roll.
Mm-hmm.
We do it all.
You know, I noticed that, you know, in the last few years, a lot of our African-American contractors, development companies have eroded. Some have been wiped out. Some have folded. What do you think is key to your success as a African-American contractor here in Kansas City?
Other than being family strong, and that's one of our mottos. We know how to bite the bullet. We know how we may work 8 hours and get paid for two. You know, the work's got to be done. But that's, you know, that's our family taking care of family. I can't do that with anybody else. I can't make you work 6 hours and pay you for two.
Right.
You know, I go to jail for that.
Well, sometimes you do, but it's okay.
But, I mean, it's it's just one. I've been blessed, right?
Being one of the most successful African-American contractors in the city, I want to extend my heartfelt thanks to you for things that you do in our community and the people that you help in our community. They can't never get you back to you and say, thank you, man. Thank you for the people that you put to work in the African-American community, man. They appreciate it. Tycon Construction Company, Mr. Forrest Tyson, Jr.
Peace.
For this program is made possible by the following sponsors and partners.